So wait a little bit. A little bit more. We had many more registrants, so we'll see if more showing up.
Well, that was Ashley playing, wasn't it? Ashley McIsaac?
Yes.
Yeah. I got a little story about Ashley, if you all have a minute before we start.
Sure.
So I'm up in Malibu and we're at a dance and my son is 4 years old at the time. And Ashley's playing. He's playing the piano. He's backing up a fiddler. And he couldn't be more than 16 or 17, 18 maybe at the time. It was 1990, I think, around there. Anyway, I didn't know who he was. So I tapped him on his shoulder between tunes and I said, do you mind if my son comes up and sits on the piano bench with you? Because he really, really is interested in music. He said, bring him up. So he sat beside Ashley the entire set, like we're talking 30 minutes. And in between songs, he wouldn't let Neil go. We just sit him down and say, so tell me about your life, where you from, blah, blah, blah. He hung on to him for like half an hour. Okay. And Neil, he talked about that for years later.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Nice. I see David's here. Hi, David Spencer. Hi, Sylvia.
Stasek. Hello, Stasek.
Hi, Kimada Shavuldig.
Ha, Kimada.
Oguma Dorica, Stasha.
Amitulich. And you mass a frask, you so.
Eskermar, Franka.
Hi.
Kimada Hershu.
Kimada. Kimada.
Leva.
Oh,
Debak.
Smisha. Thank you. I guess Cindy Hamilton. Hello. Hi.
Dana's here. And Olga's here. And Kathy's here. Hello to all.
Hi, Heather. Hello. Yeah, thank you. Great. Great to see
hello
everyone.
Hello, Alati. Give me the hash.
Hi, Robin.
Hello, Wendy. Come to hash.
Hi. Hi, Sylvia. Hi.
Hi, Kimad Hashif.
Gama.
Hello.
Kimad Hashif.
Hi, Gama. Chanyatonich. Sata van Orshan.
Sata van Orshan.
Hello, in Vancouver, Hast.
Hast down in Vancouver.
Okay,
leva. Catch the loose and dras.
Oh, hami on an aniginish, shirak aniginish.
Okay.
Yeah, hami rash on in Canada.
I got a little eye on the hami.
Oh, shug. Misha ham. Smart taking a reached.
I think it's a good job.
I wonder if we should get going, Vernak.
Well, her own minute, Ella.
Oh, so, well then.
Okay.
A few more. I know we have more registrants, so we'll just a few minutes. Hello, Rob.
Oh, Arankak.
Hi.
Hello, Bernadette.
Hello.
Jamie, Lottie, Hamwe. Can you hear them doing a screen here?
I heard Denny a shaw.
Leva, smack of air. I'm a G-Doch dollar in kitchen. I got me in cup of tea. I come on ahead.
Okay.
They wished to down rock a year, no more.
Hello, everyone. Can you see us be as Tí agus becan míl.
Má ha galeu rán fai cúpa gá hín.
Okay, well, I start then at 7:05.
Yeah, all right. That's fine. We'll start, yeah.
Okay, so fáilte orav. Welcome to Erhaley. This is season 2. So, smisha Bernac Campbell, agus hamia cool shutig vec. I'm Bernadette Campbell, and I'm living in the rear end of Little Judic, Hawthorne Road. And so I am one of your 5 hosts tonight. So I'd like to acknowledge that I'm speaking to you from the unceded ancestral territory of the Mi'kmaq. And it's because of the peace and friendship treaties in the 1700s that our ancestors, the Gaels, could settle here between 1773 and 1840. So the purpose of this Gaelic Narrative Project, or as we have called it and named it Erhaley, is to create a dignified, the purpose of the Gaelic Narrative Project is to create a dignified, welcoming, and playful space where we share moments and stories that speak to our connection to Gaelic language, to culture, and the community. And it's also to collectively make meaning and to imagine new possibilities for Gaelic in our lives and in the communities as we shed light on the stories we want to hear more of. So our plan for tonight is to reauthor. Reauthoring is about revisiting narratives or stories that shape our reality, where we may ask ourselves and each other, where we may ask ourselves to do these stories that we tell each other still ring true? Do they need to be updated? And what voices have been left out? And are there alternative narratives we need to hear? So shortly, we will be entering the breakout rooms. And you'll be in small groups. And if you'd like, you could be placed in a Gaelic-only breakout room. And in order to do that, we need you to do something. We need you to raise your Zoom hand, okay? So you need to have that little Zoom hand raised. And so in order to do that, if you look at the bottom of the screen, you'll see an icon for reactions. Click on that, and then click on the words, raise hand, and keep it raised so that Natasha and Susan can place you in the rooms. So keep the hand raised. And now I'm going to send you off to your next host, Mike Kennedy.
Apple at the Bernadette. Hello, Harston. It's Misha Michal McCulrick. Hello, everybody. My name is Mike Kennedy. I'm one of the 5 hosts tonight. And my job is to tell you a little bit about how the breakout rooms are going to work. So those of you who have been with us in the past will be familiar with this, but some of you may not be aware of how this works. So what we do is you'll get an invite. You click on that. It will take you into a smaller group, 3 or 4 people. And we'll have a chance to kind of have a little visit in there. And the only thing that'd be a little different than just having a normal conversation is that we'll post a couple of questions. I'll read them to you first, and then they'll be in the chat box if you want to refresh. And when we go into the room, we'll have about 9 minutes for this session. So roughly 3 minutes per person if we're in a group of 3. And the idea is almost if you're in a little Kaylee and you're sitting around with 3 other people and one person's going to tell a story and you just sit and listen as they tell their story. And then after they're done, they'll probably turn to you and say, hey, why don't you tell me a story? And so each person is gonna spend that little time, 3 minutes, just sharing some information. We'll just sit and listen. So the questions that we're gonna set up here, I'll give you those in a second, as I say, will be in the chat box. And there will also be a little timer in there, hopefully. I think we will see in the background, you'll see it counting down. So don't panic, it's not they're not a test. You won't get in trouble if you talk a little too long or too short, but it'll just give you a little bit of idea how much time. So if you're first, try to speak for 3 minutes and then let the next person have their turn. So the questions that we've got for you tonight, essentially when you go in there, please just introduce yourself and say, where are you calling from? And why was it important for you to visit with us tonight? So that's the big question. So I think everybody's got their hands up that wants to go into the Gaelic room, and the rest of the gang will be in with English speakers. So we'll send you off now, and Hishan Shiv and Kaun Thakin, we'll see you in a little bit.
I heard a joke about that.
Okay.
Well, welcome back, everybody. And it seems like everybody sort of approached that in a good spirit. So thank you for that accommodation. My name is Ian McLeod, Smishiain McCloach, Sauna Glasica Urahami, a company of Photocana, Dartmouth and Drasta. I'm from New Glasgow, but I live in Dartmouth now, and I'm one of the hosts. And for this next section, for the next few minutes, we're going to have a little bit of a check-in, and the other hosts and I are going to speak a little bit about how we found the experience of our first season. I guess we're going to use that word now, which I kind of like, and sort of touch in a little bit about that, and then maybe we'll do the same thing with some of you as well. I know many of the people here tonight were with us last spring, which both seems like a week ago and 40 years ago, the way time now works. So it's so good to see so many familiar faces. So I'm going to start, because that's the name that's first on my list, with Bernadette Campbell. And I'm just going to ask you, Bernadette, to maybe talk a little bit about last year, what stayed with you, you know, possibly take me to a moment that resonated with you, and we'll go from there.
Okay. Well, I was thinking about it today, and I guess I keep coming back to one story that was told, and it was actually one of the interviews I did, and that was with Nona McCall Dyke. And can everyone hear me?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. And she shared quite a story about the women in the North Shore in Cape Breton, and particularly this woman named Peggy. And I think what really struck me about that was this whole feeling of feeling connected to a community, and in particular a Gaelic community, but also how this woman, who herself was raising children, I think it was five children by herself, had the time, the love, the compassion, and the sense of connection with her neighbors to sort of kindly have these little girls visiting her children, and to make them feel special, she took some small pieces of fabric that she wove and made little white collars for the girls. And it just really struck me about that kind of love. Like, I was thinking how I'd feel if someone did something special like that if I were a little girl. And you're amongst all of these people, and we weren't always singled out as young children, I think, you know, years back. So that really struck me, just about that kind of sensitivity, connection to her neighbor, a sense of love and giving. And it sort of maybe has sort of resonated for me about how easy it is to make people feel good by the small things that we do. So that's sort of what struck me.
Thank you, Bernadette. I'm actually next on the list, and I feel like I'm not going to be able to top that. That was, you had like visual motifs, and there was a lot of stuff going on there. That was really good. When I think about last year, I just think about how much everybody was so kind of open to the process and gave so much and wanted to be here, and how much hunger there is both inside Nova Scotia and outside for this reconnection with our Gaelic identity and our culture, and how touching and moving that was, and how many people also from other places. There were a lot of people from Scotland, obviously, who joined us, and I don't want to single anybody out, but I had some great conversations with Alistair McCush, whose family are from Harris, like mine, and just the way that people were connecting and just looking forward to these Friday night sessions. That's something that will stay with me for a long time. And I'm so excited that we're back again this year and we're doing the same thing. And my hope in the session that I hosted last year, which is about the different sort of contexts Gaelic can exist in, and some that maybe people don't think of in the sort of traditional way, but also with everybody else's sessions too, was just the idea of people leaving the Gaelic Narrative Project and being inspired by what we were doing, by what each other are doing, and going out and having more and more Gaelic language and culture in their lives. And to me, to be, you know, even a small part of that is very exciting. So I'm grateful to be here. The next person on the list is Frances.
Oh, capital at the end. Hello, everyone. It's so great to be back again for another season. And I guess just thinking back to the last one, I had the real privilege and honor of talking with John Shaw. And I think one of the things that stayed with me from his visit or from our talk was and visit together online here was that image he had when he first went to Glendale in the 19, when he first came to Cape Breton. And of course he came as a young man, Harvard student, and heard about Gaelic being spoken here and made his way here and was picked up at the train and dropped off at the end of the road at Father Janangus Rankin's glebe house in Glendale, and had to make his way in and kind of figure out how to navigate this territory of this new world and that he was in at the time. So I found his stories really brought that all to life with these older people that, and they probably weren't older at the time, the people that he stayed with, that, as he said, I think the visit, he was introduced to the visit and how to make a Cayley in Glendale. So I appreciated that. And I appreciated the lines he had about the kindness, the way people, you know, in a way through this series of Ed Cayley, we're kind of reclaiming what is the meaning of the word Cayley, which is actually a house visit. And so he learned how to have a good house visit, and how the older people he mentioned were always very generous and open and special and made him feel welcome. I think he said he often went in with empty pockets and left feeling like $1 million. So yeah. I thought his way of describing that was really special.
Thank you, Frances. Mike, what about you? What sort of do you remember from last year?
I don't remember much from this week, Ian, to be quite honest. It's been that kind of week. I think there's one gift I think I took away from every session last year, or not last year, last season, I guess, because it was into this year. And I think Dale Gillis summed it up really well in your talk there, Margie, about the dance, when you asked him what was the appeal of the dance. And he said, the people are a big part of it. And then the music itself, of course, it's joyful. It's a happy music. And, you know, Dale and I, well, I was essentially Dale's next door neighbor for many years. And we hit many, many a dance over the years. And, you know, you'd roll into this place like Glencoe out in the middle of the back roads there, driving through the dark, and suddenly the church would appear and the hall would appear and you'd start to get kind of excited. And then you get in, there'd be Buddy McMaster sitting up on the stage, like one of the best ever. But Buddy wasn't there to do this sort of, you know, virtuoso violin Scottish music performance. He was there to play for the dancers. And the dancers that were there, my God, there were some just absolutely amazingly talented dancers, but they weren't there to put on a show for anybody either. They were there to connect with Buddy and his music. And so, and you'd be standing around and with each other, you'd be standing around the set and people be telling stories and catching up with friends and laughing, carrying on. And then Buddy would start and that energy would hit the set. And then the good dancers would get going and they would start to get energized. And when they get energized, everybody else's set would get energized. And when the set got energized, the hall would start to get energized. And then Buddy would get energized by the hall and he would crank it up. And then the dancers would crank it up. And there's just this ongoing process of everybody lifting each other with whatever they had to bring to the moment. And I thought when I listened to all those sessions and every participant last season, they all had that sort of same sensibility that there was this real joy in the culture itself and the expression of the culture, but it was the sharing of it that really brought it fully to life. And I just think that's a beautiful way to live. And it makes me, it's a real gift to me to be part of that kind of community.
Thank you, Mike. That is a great image. And I feel badly because when I dance, it's to show off. So I feel like I've sort of failed that test in some way.
You're the one bringing all the energy.
Margie, take us back to last year and maybe talk us through some of your favorite memories.
I would love to. It's fun to reflect, and it's great to see some new people here that this is all kind of foreign to. But I can tell you from, I was thinking back to our very first visit and the butterflies that we all had, and we were kind of nervous because it was kind of this new initiative and a lot of heart went into it, but we didn't know what the reception was going to be. And then there was this flood of people that showed up, and it turned out that our enthusiasm was met with equal parts enthusiasm, and the breakout rooms turned out to be really fun. We were nervous about them and they were fun, and the time went by so fast. And and I think to that first session too, Francis, that you had that great conversation with Dr. John Shaw, and part of it made me so lonesome in a good way, I guess, because he painted such a picture. I was so envious, I guess, of a time before I was even born, of those parties in Glendale and Boysdale. And I felt like a longing for it. But I also appreciated his perspective. Sometimes there's this funny thing I think that happens where it sometimes takes that reminder of someone coming in from away and shedding light on the beauty and riches that are here for us to see it in that way, instead of taking it for granted or not understanding how extraordinary it is. And then I felt such inspiration at the same time throughout the sessions. I think back to some of the people that we heard from in your session, Ian, of people that just took initiative all on their own and did it all on their own. They just said, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and do it. And they gave themselves permission. And then I think of Kenneth McKenzie's great quote in the last session with yours, Mike, where he said, speaking of the Gaelic Medium School, which since then has opened as of September. And he said, we're not just raising Gaelic speakers, we're raising Gaels. And it left us on such a high note. So I'm happy to be back. I'm happy that everyone's here. And let's see what season two brings.
Thank you so much, Mark. Oh, Bernadette.
Can I add one more?
You can add two things.
Okay, one more. One thing I just remembered was Mickey. I loved hearing him telling a story and his big laughter. And I never met him before, but I did last week. And he's everything on that video, if anyone goes back to view him telling the story and then joining in that chorus with Colin Watson. He's everything that you see. He's beautiful and he's welcoming, and he just really can touch our souls. So I just wanted to just bring that little image in, that all these collection of narrative projects, or each session that we had last year, is all online for us to have a look at again if you feel inclined.
Thank you, Bernadette. And I see that got the thumbs up from Alistair, so that's good. And thank you to all of the hosts for sharing those wonderful memories and thoughts with us. And now I would invite everybody here who was present for any of the sessions last year to just maybe take a moment and type in the chat memories that stay with you, things that, you know, that have resonated and you've carried forward. And I may read some of those out as we go. And I think there are actually a couple of people who not to show you behind the curtain, but we coordinated this a bit, who may have some of those memories to share with us. So I'm going to ask Lorene Murphy, who I believe is here, to maybe speak to that a little bit. Or also possibly not.
No, can you hear me?
Oh, there you go. Sorry. Take it away, Lorene.
I'm sorry.
No, not at all.
No.
Well, I just want to say that I certainly enjoyed the sessions, you know, the last season. I look forward to them every Friday night. It's funny. I could even have other plans to say, oh, no, my Gaelic session is on Friday night. I'm not missing that. But a couple of memories that I'd like to share was in one of the breakout sessions, the first season they had said, you know, some people said, do you speak Gaelic? Do you want to speak Gaelic? And I know I said, well, no, I don't speak Gaelic. Maybe Beckon, you know. And this lady, whoever she was, she said, when people ask, do you speak Gaelic? You don't have to be fluent in Gaelic to say that you're a Gaelic speaker. You can say you're a Gaelic speaker. And, you know, that gave me some confidence. I felt like, what a good thing to say to make a person feel a little better in the breakout room. You don't have to be a fluent speaker. And that kind of put me toward the theme for the sessions, because I know your theme for the next sessions is galore, if I can say that properly. So I can speak enough or I can speak plenty, but it's whatever makes you happy. So the sessions last time inspired me to go on in my Gaelic. And I made that promise to myself. So I enrolled at St. Evex into the Gaelic program, but I also said that I was going to, I wanted my grandchildren to, you know, certainly remember their culture and heritage, their identity. So my oldest granddaughter was only 7. So after the session last time, Bernadette had the lovely Gaelic camp at her place. And I know a lot of you were involved in that, so I'm not going to say names, but my granddaughter went to that. And I couldn't have been more proud. And one night I was reading her story. I'm just going to share this. We were doing Charlotte's Web and the topic of manure came up with the pig. She's a city girl. So I said to her, do you know what manure is? And she said, no, Nanny. So I was explaining to her what manure was. And she said to me, Nanny, did you know that the Gaels used pea in the milling frolic? So I'm just saying, and when she used the word Gaels, I couldn't believe it, because I was an adult before I learned that term that we were referred to as Gaels. So I just felt so proud, and it was all because of the lovely, you know, how we thrive. So I just wanted to share, and it's so intergenerational, what, you know, all this learning, and I think that's very positive too. There's all ages learning. And I think that's just so positive. So I'm enjoying and I'm looking forward to the next session.
Thank you so much, Lorraine. That was a great story. It was edgy, but not too edgy. And I think that it really, your message of like learning the language and really just going forward with it, I think is a wonderful thing to take away. I'm just going to read a few comments. So Alistair says, Va Gaelic. Ak of Homa, I assume he means ek ein, but possibly not. I'm also seeing the word community is appearing a lot, connection. There's also connecting with old friends, a lot of great memories. Again, community, that's coming up a lot. The chat with Hector was a wonderful thing. I think Robert Pringle may also have some comments, so I just ask you to maybe step forward now, Robert.
Jake, how many jewels on a barrel? 33 now, so picture
get it.
Well, I torch them coin, well, a whole quarter of not, atcha the on the sun Gaelic agree, I guess. Shishin Ronship, atcha room, a son the Akumal. And do of us acting like the kind of acting, I guess. A shin called sonature. I guess. Hi, and a doy hashin back in the Abishok, we breen out a gal, Saline and Jew. Ah, hi, good job. Hi, me Abishok of the breen re slower, like El Miola, at an etterly. I mean, breen re more computer in this. Hashin down. I guess. Hashin, hi, hashin a poor. Has she been doing a doy? Gaelic be natural, agree. I guess you shouldn't have a bitter fine when the session is drawn, I guess. Tapalet four.
Oh, Tapaletsa. I guess, well, I see that Lottie was doing a live translation and I'm at least at 60%, so I'm feeling pretty happy about that. I'm just gonna ask, just for maybe another minute or so, if anybody has any more comments to type, I can share those and then we'll move on. But I really appreciate everybody taking that step and sharing what they remember and how they felt about our last session. So we're just getting some thanks to Lottie for that. Okay, well, I think maybe what we'll do then is move on. And I think Francis is the next person who is going to take care of us.
All right, happily, Vula. Thanks everyone for those comments. That was lovely to think back to the last season. And I'm gonna bring us into what we're going to work on in this season for Ed Haley. And Laureen mentioned our theme, and I'll just say a little bit about it. And when it came to thinking about this season of Ed Haley, our conversations in the group took us to this proverb, and which we featured on a Facebook ad. I don't know if we have that, we can share that, Natasha, that ad. But the proverb, it states, ha geleor homa ricurum, which means enough is as good as a feast. And it reminded me of a time too. I remember talking, I was having a conversation with Shannon McMullen, who we know, many people know as a great Gaelic teacher and advocate. And she said one time, do you know, like geleor means both enough and plenty. And it got us thinking about how there's a lot in that word. In our last season, Amber said, she talked about her great-grandmother and the older Gaels, that they didn't jump on the hamster wheel and run like a maniac, she said, and that in cultivating, reclaiming her language and her culture, she's cultivating this sense of enoughness. So we thought there's a lot to unpack here. And to look at this word geleor, it might point to a philosophy or a way of living that we badly need in our time, where we understand that enough is plenty. So in season two of the Narrative Project, which begins next on January 7th, we'll touch on this theme. And right now we thought we'd kick it off with a visit with Hector MacNeil. And Bernadette and I went to visit him this week and just asked him a bit about the word geleor and how that connected with his life. So now we'll watch that together.
Echen, hashin ekan thoi akadis. Agus kabel shin.
Hashin an a beir hashto, an a shawn in kipreite. Shawn da adjur for a danik wa na dunya akamsa, an a hanik at the bus, a barai. As a verb, can get plenty, so enough, ah, plenty, can a noun. So, not a canis to, I've been smudging ever since. Not a canis to, not a gapris to, not a walrus to, a vacal shin. How a kettle die roots in the mill. I guess how a poilacus. So, how a kettle and a root, gonna be smudging.
That in Jackshiver or Toko. Kimara Nokshit as Zerbea.
Well, in this year, Hushin Dorash, well, me and the three Fikatank can, Well, but still, in fact, the simpleton and you, marketing and whatever, trails and you. Ah, how pouches to she and that can you? I'm ahead of go better of land style in the Sydney. I guess my go be one heed, yeah. Ah, hello, pouches I can get you. My god, it more like I guess, there are Hannah seen Sulis at Shaw, get me a cash show, Kaima Hoka on a portage, Gashkin about Sydney. There are Hannah seen the Shaw, get me a cash show, but do you be told the Hassas? A Belgian Perrinia on the soul, I had your shop. I guess like a mashup of the Norsian. I know it's good old man of ours, but doing you talk over that geisha, I guess I'm a salmon and the sugars and teas on the shame of Shinda. I couldn't tell us that she in general yelled, as me means my very hard down it, that she homos could you. Tors Kudjikuk, the dog, Graham Mahe. As you hear, it's like a hotdog. They see you sandbar on, I guess, pawn it to the side, sandbar. Well, I started making you sound, well, can you, me in the town you are. I guess, Hashin Sous, Mahin's Donny. I guess, Hunishin Trush, Snab, Ursh, the Rash, to the side, sandbar. Ursh, about Kiat in your mouth. I guess Yin Shin Shin my uncle. I guess Roina Gaff going, Gaff Bones and Gaff to do a mode and cast a second. That's what. I guess Kai Shin Shias, I guess Lashin Agias go, Gaff, talk of the Trosk. I guess when you listen, who should let it you know, key at you. Ach, bagging you around, horse monkle, I should get out, fag and you know, who should get out. I guess everybody's been genuine now. I guess one the trush. I guess like a salwan or a gunchermukhug or rack and egg or something. I could be in a chichina study, the ward failure. I guess my guy che had racket to trust the moo as a grain that you could be getting cockroach. So, can you bashing this shin? You got a pilot, the frosk, out in Tokel, Ochella, Rocham, which is still at their torso side wallet, Rocham, which is back, so wallet, Ella. I guess, Strach, your peas, cod, you know. Frosk, you know, he's got Ganika, Narva, and grow salches. I guess back in the old now, but poiler out for seconds. But she endorsed to say, I fear, because I should have thought it was a St. Hall. But poiler more the rusk out where the kind the building, that's in Tokyo. I guess back in the old now, no Bulgarian call. I guess I'm mostly a Korean tourist, the store on the Noaka, like Joey McKinnon. Joey ADH, Fenix Fish. Agus, Bob, Shachkin, Elm, Hoy, Joey McKinnon, Baloney, Abba, Kerbeck, Haro, Mo, Mashaf, Abbeck, Gunjit, three orly, the Lear, the second. Well, Hulladuni Bruin, Ere Baloney, Shem, Hope was to survive. God, Jeffra, from the Baloney, Bo, in a second. Agus, I guess Hanukkah Nail, a Hadurth and Baloney has the second. But Nail, the Dolman Gores is a horse on Big Show. Good on Baloney, good, I guess, but man, I shared in Baloney Yellow. I gave it to Fura Kustitani, where the rocket to Sulas Kanyakus. And had Jake Mila, had drive it to Jake Mila, Tirk as a Baloney, but she knows. You like to ask the heels in the year. I guess horseshoe and baloney dick. I guess ye of that man. Oh, all the things are really for the bosses. I don't care, Jeff. I guess she will pick a hell. The baloney said by a little priest on Ellen Dolly, her box, her comers, I guess, these even smudging everything. I guess.
Wow. Hello. Wasn't that wonderful? Oh, Hector has such a way as a storyteller, of course, and he might be on the call tonight too, but thank you so much to Francis and Bernadette for visiting with him, and then of course to Hector for sharing so much. There's such wisdom in his words. And certainly I think one of the messages that I'm hearing from that is the gratitude and appreciation, and it makes a lot. So the hope is that we'll be speaking to that this session, more of that. So we'll move right along into our next segment. We're gonna go back into breakout rooms, and we've got a little bit more time, although we might be running a bit behind. So we're gonna take maybe 7 minutes each. in a group of three. This one will be all in English, actually, because we're going to be chatting a bit more at length, if you will. And so I'm going to, or someone, myself or someone will put the questions in the chat. I'll just go over them with you. There it is, Natasha, she's right on the money. So the questions are that this is the season of giving. And was there a gift that you received from Hector stories or other contributions tonight already? And take us to a moment. So tell us a story. Take us to a moment when you experienced a sense of gulod, or perhaps when you felt there wasn't enough. And so I just want to make a quick reminder before we break out into our rooms. This will be about 20 minutes thereabouts. So everyone can take their time, take your minutes. It's okay to listen and think. So if there's dead air, that's okay. And it's a gift that we can give someone to listen to their story. So that's what a big part of this whole initiative is as well. And so we're with new people, so take some time to introduce yourself. It's okay to have a little visit at the beginning. After all, we're all just beautiful strangers, if not good friends. So so the questions should follow you into the chat, and we'll let the experts place us where they will. We'll see you in.
Hello, folks. Welcome back. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do something called the harvest, for those of you who haven't been with us before. And that's a chance to just reflect on some of the conversations you've heard tonight, the offerings that Hector gave, discussions in the breakout room, anything that struck with you. And we'd just like to take a moment and think about that. And as you come memories and ideas come to mind, go ahead and tap those into the chat room. And the kind of questions we'd like to throw out to you to think about, and those will be in the chat box as well, is did anything surprise you in what you heard or said, heard or what was said? Were any themes coming up for you in the different conversations? And did anything get sparked in you? So when you're ready, just please go ahead and just start typing away. And we'll leave you, we've got about 7 or 8 minutes here to do that. And maybe I'll read a few as they start to come in. See, Heather says, love the idea that gulod means both enough and plenty. It's a lot about how a language is populated.
Oh, my chat feature doesn't work for some reason.
That's okay, Patrick. Sorry about that. Small bologna, tastier versus large bologna. Small amount, tastier than large quantity. Led me to think, a Cayley is plenty. What more do I need?
Is Liam Borg, why are you still fast?
Then says, we may need to experience not having enough in order to fully appreciate enough. Madonna here says, I love the conversation about enough. Growing up in Cape Breton, enough was the running theme. It took the edge of worry off for my mother. See, Cindy Hamilton says, I love the themes and the stories talking about people. When they pass it, keep them alive somehow. A reminder of the importance of community and how connected we feel with the sharing, no matter how far apart some of us are. Jen shares with us, there's a difference between harvesting and depleting. Depik says, in an upcoming time of modern excessive commercialism, it is grounding to feel the profound sense of plenty, leór. Jamie McDonald says, my granny used to say, I have gracious plenty. Ostriana Baron, enough might just be one of the most important things we could cultivate in a world that desperately needs to find its way to sustainability. All right, folks, please feel free to carry on, add your thoughts if anything more comes to mind. Some of these are going to be captured and put on the website if you'd ever like to go back and see what people have to say. And I'm going to turn it over now to Francis.
Hi, everyone. I'm going to tell you what's coming up in Ed Haley for the next session. The next session is on January 7th, the same times on Friday night, January 7th. And our guest, the way I came across our guest is when we thought we'd focus on the word gileor and what it means, I Googled enough is plenty. And I came up with, there were two books by that name. And they actually both are from Irish writers. And so there was one that intrigued me. It was from a woman by the name of Anne Ryan. And she wrote a book called Enough is Plenty, Private and Public Policies for the 21st Centuries. And it was published in 2009. So I did a little more digging and I found Anne's email. And I talked to her. We communicated by email and then talked on Zoom. And I asked her if she would come and speak to us on the Narrative Project. And so I'm delighted to say that Anne, who is an Irish speaker, and she's a university lecturer and conducts workshops on seminars on sustainable living and positive futures and balanced living. So she's going to come and speak about in a little bit more depth about her philosophy of enough. And I was also hoping to bring on someone from Nova Scotia as well. So I hope that you might be able to join us on January 7th and have a conversation with Anne, who lives in Kildare, Ireland. So thank you. And I think now we are going to conclude it. And Bernadette's going to come back on to conclude our session. And before, and as Bernadette's coming on and say before, if you haven't registered, be sure to register for the upcoming sessions. They're starting on January 7th and they'll be going every Friday until February 18th. So we hope to see you there.
Hi, there was a question in the chat whether we're using the same address. So maybe that could be clarified before we leave tonight. I think that I saw that in the chat. So we're at the end of our evening and it's a time for us to reflect, but also a time for us to say thanks. And so the person we really want to thank, there's many, but one in particular is our guest, Hector MacNeil. So Modern Thang, Papalet Gumoda, Hector, Ersan Nanayakan. So we appreciate that so, so much. I love visiting at your home and listening to your Gaelic. It was beautiful. We also want to thank our technicians. This is big work when we're trying to place folks in the Gaelic rooms. We'll get that hopefully next time. There were just so many, which is a wonderful thing to have 30 or more people wanting to be in Gaelic rooms. So it took a little more time and we'll do some tweaking in our introduction. So that'll give the technicians, which is Natasha and Susan, who have been with us last season and are here again. So we appreciate that so, so much for the work that you do and the patience that you have. We also wanted to recognize Liam McDonald. He was our videographer who collected some of the video clips and made it into a nice piece that you could go to How We Thrive and see where Ed Haley's videos are and where you can see the recordings of our programs each session. So please go back there and revisit because every time you get something new from seeing the videos. We also have to thank How We Thrive, which is one of our host organizations that brought us to this great project and have worked and helped us with our skills and our questions and our approach to all of this. So, and Susan has been a big part of that. And we want to thank the team, all the team members here, because we're willing to keep on looking for wonderful guests and speakers and to be involved in this and to work together. We've enjoyed it very, very much. So it's time for us to say goodnight or goodbye. And we're going to sign off with you in Gaelic. And as we're doing that, we invite you when we're done to share with us your language or Gaelic or a phrase or some seasonal greeting in a language that you feel like offering to us. And we also have Margie that's going to play us out. So I want to wish everyone Benachag na nawig orav.
Nalikana guiv.
Nalikana guiv o huladunia agus blina vaur.
Okay.
Udahike.
Nalikriya. Sure. No, no, I'm sure that you this blina vaur galer.
Happy
life, Gamod, by Homer, Gur Fiking, I guess. Nolachri a gaiv.
Hi, Varak. Nolachon.
Hi, Tap. Yeah.
Slan, Slan Lal.
Ha ha. Viva.
Nolach bagaiv ula morin tang. Horsa ding gmoor.
Nolach theo gaiv. For Alapa, who's playing about Ur Edihiki.
Marhana satan in yours, Hamidol Ainge.
Oh, I was going to say, is that actually Mary Jane Lamond on my computer screen? I am so honored. I love your music.
Well, okay, great. I'm so glad. And here I am in my hoodie. I can't even having sworn to wash my face today, but, you know, that's okay. Oh, Brian.
Oh, Lena.
Okay, we can't get into that now, but there's a...
Are you going to... Okay. Margie's going to play a few tunes for
yeah,
us.
Yeah, yeah. Big shit bad. Good night. Play bad.
Okay. Keep,
keep chatting. I'll just play in the background. Keep chatting. How do I do this?
Thank you,
Valor. Thank you, Valor.
Thank you,
Valle Bullock.
Thank you, Valle.